Welcome. This is the 12th of August, 2022. It's the Jenkins Platform Special Interest Group. Today's agenda items include open action items, require Java 11, Java 17 support, and DevOps World, where we'll talk about Contributor Summit and the Contributing to Open Source Workshop. Any other topics we should add to the agenda for today?
I don't think so.
Okay. All right. So on the action items, we've got plugin installation manager docs. And this one is still open. What it is the plugin installation manager tool is the preferred way to do command line installation of plugins, but it's missing some use case documentation. And we've got a draft pull request that came in and was closed to add that to Jenkins.io. It really belongs in the plugin. So we've got work to do there. It'll be a while still. The other was one that Bruno has identified. The preview suffix has been removed from the JDK 17 controller images, but it's not been removed from the JDK 17 agent images. And we aren't in preview anymore. We believe JDK 17 works and is ready for use. So we need to remove those, but the issues are here in the backlog. We'll look to hope that someone will take those on. And if not, we may get them solved over the course of the next few weeks ourselves. And then I had an action item to share credentials. I've done it with one of the two successfully. I haven't done it with the other one yet. So update on that one. Any questions on the action items?
Nope.
Okay, next topic then was require Java 11. So the latest story here is that we've now got Jetty 10 instead of Jetty 9. So that's the version of Jetty that requires Java 11 at minimum. Jetty is the web container that we use to deliver HTTP. And so it's now running Jetty 10, and that will be a proposed backport for the 2.361.1 release line. And there are a number of other backports. We did a review yesterday in Doc's office hours with the release lead, Chris Stern, so that he's aware what the process looks like there, et cetera. So Kevin, thanks to you for the work we did during Doc's Office Hours Europe and later that day, I was able to highlight to Chris Stern that progress is going forward. So we're getting ready for this. We know we've got a lot to do there. We've got to do the change log. We've got to do the upgrade guide. We want a blog post, and we also want a CDF blog post for it. So still lots to do, but good progress. No reports of any regressions related to Java 11, as far as I can see. So it looks very promising that the backports list is a little larger than typical this time, but not huge. Any questions on require Java 11?
No, that's nice. On the good news.
It is good news. It's very good news. Basel and others have done really, really great work there to get us ready for that. Then Java 17 support, it's been in since 2.357, and the infrastructure team is planning to upgrade one or more of the instances to use Java 11 or Java 17. So we'll look forward to that. They won't do ci.jenkins.io as the first target because it's such a large installation. We like to get our experience first on the smaller installations to be sure that they're healthy and well-behaved. Mm-hmm. Anything else on Java 17?
No, said that I'm using it on a daily basis.
Very good. Oh, that means you're probably also using it on ARM then, not just on Intel boxes.
For the time being, only on Intel. I haven't tried yet in ARM. To tell you the truth, it's so hot nowadays that I switch off all my ARM devices just in case, because it's getting too hot. Not that they are hitting more than the x86, of course, they are not, but anyway, maybe next week.
Very wise thing. I know Java 17 has been working for me on my ARM devices. So I'm glad to hear that that you're using ARM still. That's great. DevOps world, next topic then. So we've got the Contributor Summit coming on Tuesday the 27th. And we know about platform topics for Java 11 and for Java 17. Bruno, are there any other topics that you think are platform specific? Will we likely talk about ARM support there, or?
ARM support is in its beginning, and we are waiting for some work from Temurin and from Alpine. So unfortunately, we don't cover everything. So I would prefer that we communicate about that when everything is stable. I'm having a look almost every day at the progress of the Alpine beats, for example, and it's not stable, and it won't be in the following week. So no, that's for another event, if you don't mind.
Okay, good. All right. So not likely. Great.
No.
All right. The next item is that Bruno, Jean-Marc Mason, and I will be doing a contributing to open source workshop there. And we're looking forward to other volunteers helping us if they're available. The contributing to open source workshop will highlight how people in the workshop in 90 minutes can make substantial progress to modernize one or more of a collection of plugins. And that plugin modernization will actually use a tutorial from Jenkins.io as the basis, so that we'll know that we're ready for that. We'll also then use that as a way to teach people in Hacktoberfest how to do the same kinds of things, so that we can have a nice step up as people assist in modernizing plugins. Any questions there?
No.
All right, then let's call done for today. Thanks very much.